In this video, we're going to cover the no T-wall method, which divides the T-wall into two separate walls, saving time and labor but requiring two separate pours. First, construct your straight wall the exact same way you would usually construct a straight wall, except where your T-wall is going to go. Place your L-bar each course. We recommend leaving it at this diagonal angle at this point to allow more of the bar to be covered in the initial pour, as well as stay out of the way when working around it. Rasp it into place just enough to where the next block can lie flush on top of it. Pour the wall like you normally would, and once it is set, cut out the foam for your T-wall. Bend the L-bar rebar to where it is horizontal, and then stack your T-wall like you would a straight wall. This method saves a lot of time and labor. This method is very useful logistically in certain settings where it makes more sense to simply have a pour day for the outer walls and a pour day for the inner walls. You'll spend less time preparing each T-wall for a single pour day. In this example, dividing the outer walls and inner walls of this multi-story building eliminated 52 T-walls from the project, saving the builder a tremendous amount of time and labor. The same process could then be repeated for each additional floor, eliminating another 52 T-walls, plus 35 more on floors 2 through 4, in the extended building shown here. Trying to keep this many T-walls straight and plumb would have been a nightmare, but by dividing the walls, they simplified the situation immensely. Thanks for watching, and if you have any further questions, please give us a call.